Hello students, today we are going to start first chapter of science, that is nutrition in plants. So firstly we should know about nutrients. The chemical substances which are present in the food and fulfill the requirements of the body are known as nutrients. Means whatever the chemical substances, that may be carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, roughages, water, all which are present in the food and required to fulfill the requirements of the body are known as nutrients. Now nutrition, it is a process of taking up the nutrients and its utilization in the body to release energy is known as nutrition. Means when these chemical substances are taken up by the body firstly, and then chemical processes are being going on in the body, and these nutrients are then utilized by the body and energy is released, which is utilized in the various body processes. Now depending on the mode of obtaining food, all the organisms are divided into two groups. First one is the autotrophs. As itself explains, auto means self and tropic means nutrition. Means those plants which can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis are known as autotrophs, such as green plants and green algae. Means they do not depend on others for their food, they have the capability to produce or to prepare their own food. Second one is the heterotrophs. Those plants and animals which cannot prepare their own food and depends on others for their food requirements are known as heterotrophs. Means they do not have such kind of a machinery that helps in the process of formation of photosynthesis and all. So they have to depend on other animals or plants for their food requirements, such as animals, parasites, saprophytes, insectivorous plants, all are heterotrophs. Now coming to next, photosynthesis. As the term explained, photo means light and synthesis means putting together. As you can see in this diagram, here is a plant. In the leaf, the sunlight is coming, falling on the leaf, carbon dioxide is coming in the leaf from the atmosphere, chlorophyll is already a chemical natural substance which is present in the leaf, and water is present in the soil which is taken up in the leaf through the roots. Finally, the food is prepared in the leaf in the form of glucose, but it is stored in the form of starch, and byproduct oxygen is also released in the process of photosynthesis. Now, it is a process by which green plants prepare their own food with the help of carbon dioxide from air, water from soil, chlorophyll which is present in the leaf in the presence of sunlight is known as photosynthesis. Equation for the photosynthesis, we can write this process also in the form of an equation, such as carbon dioxide plus water give rise to glucose and oxygen in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. If we chemically write this equation with the help of chemical formulas, so a balanced chemical reaction will be like 6 molecules of CO2 plus 6 molecules of water give rise to 1 molecule of glucose plus 6 molecules of oxygen. This is a complete balanced chemical equation for the photosynthesis. Now, leaves are called the food factories of the plant, as synthesis of food occurs in them. Now, there are four essential components of photosynthesis. The first one is the carbon dioxide. As the leaves get carbon dioxide from the air through the tiny pores, which are known as stomata, and these are present in the leaf surface. Each pore is known as stoma, and which is surrounded by the guard cells, which controls the opening and closing of the stomata. As you can see in this figure, these are the two guard cells. These two guard cells contain many chloroplasts, having each cell a nucleus, and at the center of the guard cell, there is a stomata. When the guard cell becomes open, stomata becomes open and carbon dioxide enter inside the cell. And when the guard cells become closed, stomata also becomes closed. So there will be no entry of the carbon dioxide. Second one is the water. Plants absorb water from the soil. There are xylem vessels, which are pipe-like structures which extends from roots to the leaves of the plants and helps in conduction and transportation of water. Also, nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium are also transported through these pipe-like structures which are known as xylem vessels. Third one is the chlorophyll. Also, we already have explained that it is a green pigment which is naturally present in the leaves and it helps in capturing energy from the sunlight. It is present in the chloroplast and there are thousands of chloroplasts present in a single leaf. So, leaf contains chloroplast and chloroplast contains chlorophyll. And the last one is the sunlight. As we know that sun is the ultimate source of energy for all the living organisms. And photosynthesis will occur only in the presence of oxygen. It will not occur in the absence of sunlight, that is at the night time. Photosynthesis occurs only at the daytime. This is all about photosynthesis.